greatest magicians have something to learn from Mr. Mistopheles' conjuring turn. Rumpelteazer were a notorious couple of cats, as knockabout clowns, quick change comedians, tightrope walkers, and acrobats. They had an extensive reputation. They made their home in Victoria Grove. That was merely their center of operation, for they were incurably given to rove. If the area window was found ajar and the basement looked like a field of war, if a tile or two came loose on the roof, which presently ceased to be waterproof, if the drawers were pulled out from the bedroom chests and you couldn't find one of your winter vests, or after supper one of the girls suddenly missed her Woolworth pearls, and most of the time they left it at that. Mungo Jerry and Rumpelteazer had a wonderful way of working together, and some of the time you would say it was luck, and some of the time you would say it was weather. They'd go through the house like a hurricane, and no sober person could take his oath. Was it Mungo Jerry or Rumpelteazer? Or could you have sworn that it mightn't be both? And when you heard a dining room smash, or up from the pantry there came a loud crash, or down from the library came a loud ping from a vase which was commonly said to be Ming, then the family would say, now which was which cat? It was Mungo Jerry and Rumpelteazer, and there's nothing at all to be done about that. About that.
McCavity's a mystery cat. He's called the Hidden Paw, for he's the master criminal who can defy the law. He's the bafflement of Scotland Yard, the Flying Squad's despair, for when they reach the scene of crime, McCavity's not there. He's broken every human law. He breaks the law of gravity. His powers of levitation would make a fakir stare. And when you reach the scene of crime, McCavity's not there. McCavity's a ginger cat. He's very tall and thin. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunk on him. His brow is deeply lined with thought. His head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect. His whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he's always wide awake! McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity, for he's a fiend in feline shape, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square, but when the crime's discovered, then McCavity's not there. Cavities not there.
Come one, come all, the Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball, Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball,
Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all, the Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball, Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all, the Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball.
Jellicle cats meet once a year at the Jellicle ball, where we all rejoice, and the Jellicle leader will soon appear and make what is known as the Jellicle choice. When old Deuteronomy, just before dawn, through a silence you feel you could cut with a knife, announces the cat who can now be reborn and come back to a different Jellicle life. For waiting up there is the heavy side layer, with wonders one Jellicle only will see. And Jellicles ask, because Jellicles dare, who will it be?
When the day's hustle and bustle is done, then the Gumby Cat's work is but hardly begun. And when all the families are dead and asleep, she tucks up her skirts to the basement to creep. She's deeply concerned with the ways of the mice.
Their behavior's not good and their manner's not nice.
So when she has got them lined up on the matting, she teaches them
music, crocheting and catting.
But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, then the Gumby Cat's work is but hardly begun. She thinks that the cockroaches
just need employment
to prevent them from
idle and wanton destroyment.
So she's born from the lot of disorderly louts, a troop of well-disciplined, helpful Boy Scouts,
with a purpose in life and a good deed to do.
And she's even created a Beatles tattoo.
We'll be right back. Ey, deine Leute, hüt sie in Wien, Meister Wien. Mavry, with a sign,
thank you.